the theory that is called Big Five model, Levi-Strauss-Goldsberg Big Five model. So he, having some kind of deviations opinion from the previous two traits approaches, one is called Cattell, other one is called Alport. So do you know how many classification Alport made? How many classification Alport made? How many classification of the Alport? So anyone can tell, three or four? How much the Alport made the classifications in his theory?
Three, sir.
Threes, yeah. So what are the names? One is called coordinate traits, central traits,
or central, secondary.
Yeah.
Central and secondary traits.
Yes, so this is that. So the problem he found from the Alport, he made the theory only the three traits of approaches only. So it's very small, it's very small. Then he come for the, he do this some kind of critical review in the Cattell's theory. The Cattell's theory is highlighting the more than nearly 16. So see here, one is very low in the case of only three. In the case of the Cattell's is more, it's nearly 16. So he feel that the Alport theory is very low factors he is discussing. In the case of the Cattell's, he is discussing very high level. So therefore, it's very complicated to leave the future research and all. That's what he did. He made the classification, only the five classification. So instead of going with the low level or the high level, he make it some kind of moderate level of personality traits that is called Big Five model. It means that he divide the people's traits into five factors. Five factors. And most of the psychologists, they're adopting the five factors only. Even the previously the Sana asked the question, so what is a critical review? So the same critical review, he made it in the case of the Levi-Strauss-Goldsberg. He found that there is a problem with Alport's theory, because Alport theory talking about only the three traits only. From the three traits, we cannot come for any conclusion about the person's personality traits. Then similarly, he read the Cattell theory. From this, he come for some conclusion that we could not go with this much of nearly 16 personality factors. We could not go with this because it may lead some kind of confusion in it. And also the 16 PF theory, see here the 16 PF theory, I already mentioned with the one diagram. The diagram is what it highlight in the sense, each factor is having some kind of relationship. So it's already having the relationship between the two variables or three variables. Better to compare the three variables to single factors, because if you go with different more number of variables or components, it making a lot of confusion to the learner side, as well as the those are going to measure from the side also make much confusion may arise. That is why he believed that no need to go for the small, no need to go for much. So we can go with moderate number of the personality traits. That is why he made this theory into the five components of the Big Five model. He's the man is called Goldsberg. Just I'm going to brief the small brief introduction about him. He was born in January 28, 1938. He's a 20th century psychologist, basically from American alma mater, Harvard University, University of Michigan. His occupation is a psychologist only. He's an employer of University of Oregon. This is a small brief. But he's an eminent psychologist and professor of emeritus at the University of Oregon. He's closely associated with the lexical hypothesis that any culturally important personality characteristic will be represented in the language of the culture. So he's believed like this. His hypothesis, he made the hypothesis, led to five factor structure of personality traits adjectives. That adjectives he made it call as a big five. Sometimes the peoples may call as a Wosen model, O-C-E-A-N, Wosen, okay. Big five model or Wosen, some kind of similarity names, even the Levi-Strauss-Goldsberg they provided. Even most of the psychologists, now they're adopting this model only. They're not using the 16 PF theory or in the Alport theory, because this model is somewhat neutral compared to the other model, other theories. That's why most of the psychologists, those are doing the research now, they're adopting the Big Five model in the name of the Ozone. So, okay. then he's a creator and he's contributed a lot. He's a creator of international personality item sport. And he's having your own website. That website, we can use it for the public domain personality matches. And he's having the lot of controversy. I already mentioned the contemporary with the other people. And what is classification according to the Goldsberg in the sense? This is the answer. He divide the peoples into Wasson model. O represent openness, C represent consultiveness, E represent extroversion, A represent agreeableness, N represent neuroticism. So like this, he combined or he made the attempt into five components model based factors of the personality. Just this is a modest talking. So previously he knows the 16 PF, but out of the 16 PF, he combined all the things in company to within five. And here also these are traits. So like the factors, openness, consentiveness, extroversion, agreeableness, and neuroticism. Why is called Wasson in the sense, see the first letter of the Wasson, openness, O, consentiveness, first letter C, extroversion, first letter E, then the agreeableness, the first letter G, the neuroticism, first letter N. Therefore, the particular theory, it may call as a Wasson model also. And we already know that the traits are the bipolar. One is a low level, other one is high level. In the case of the openness, there is a practical, opposite for the practical is not practical. Okay, it's like a curious and conventional people and prepare our routines. This is the lowest score. In the case of the high score, curious, void range interest, they are independent. The conscientiousness, so how they much concentrate to work in this. So impulsiveness, careless, disorganized in the case of low score. In the case of high score, high level, hardworking, dependable, and organized. In the case of the extroversion, you know the difference between the extroversion and introversions. This is called as an extroversion. The opposite is called as an introversion. So the low level is called introversion. The high level thing is called extroversion. But he make it as an extroversion. If high level extroversion, the people having high score. If the people the low level, they have the low level extroversion. It means the low level extroversion is they are treated as the introversion only. But he is not using the term introversion. Instead of that, he is using the term low introverted, so low extroversion or high extroversion, like this may be classified. In the case of the agreeableness, how we are cooperative with others. For this, the low level people are critical and uncooperative with others, they are very suspicious to for each one. In the case of the high level people, they are very helpful, trusting, all, then they have the very empathetic characteristics. In the case of the neuroticism people, the low people are very calm, even temper and secure. So these people having some kind of problem in the case of neuroticism, like they are anxious, they have a lot of stress, unhappiness, prone to negative emotions. So in this manner, he made it a five component base. That five components mean keep as a small term as a Wasson. The same thing here discussing. So the openness, it measuring how creative, imaginative, down to earth or pragmatic someone. So these things only me for them. Just I'm going to brief it this one. The openness means the characteristics such as imagination and insight only discussing. People who are high in these traits also tend to have a broad range of interest. They're curious about the world and other people and eager to learn new things and enjoy new experiences. So that people having this things like creativity, curious, sensitiveness, aesthetic and all. In the case of the low, people who have the high in the traits tend to be more adventure and creative, I already mentioned. But the people having the low in these traits are often much more traditional and mean struggle with abstract thinking. So these are the problem for them in the case of the low people, low level. Then next one is called consentiveness. So normally it measures the preference for an organized approach to life in contrast to a spontaneous one, which is already there. So generally, if you think about this feature, no, of this particular dimension, include high level of thoughtfulness, good impulse control, and goal-directed behavior. Normally, the high consciousness people tend to be organized and mindful of details. The plan ahead, think about how their behavior affects others, or mindful of deadlines. So this is called consentiveness. In the case of the extroversions, you are already familiar with extroversions. Some people, they use the term extro, EXT or O also, extroversion. So is characterized by the excitability, sociability, and talkativeness, assertiveness, and high amounts of emotion expressiveness. People who are in high extroversions, they are normally outgoing, social, friendly, talkative. This characteristics he knows. Being around others, people help them to feel energized and excited. So this is a great features of the extroversion people. If they're having the low level of extroversions, they normally is a reserved and tend to more reserved and have less energy to expand in social settings. Social events can feel draining, and introverts often require period of solitude and quiet in order to recharge. So this kind of having the problem with them, and their very seriousness in all the context. So that is a problem with the low level of extroversion people. The next is called agreeableness. So how we are accepting the things. Here it's talking about that one. Normally the agreeable people, they are very friendly. They are very cooperative with each other. So this traits, it's talking about the how you are adopting the other people. That's the thing only discussing. Suppose some people, they are not accepting any other people. They are not agreeing with the other's views and all. So that people characteristic may be as assertive and then devious and autonomous and all. Then finally, the neuroticism. So the neuroticism's measure to tendency to experience mood swing and emotion. It may checking the emotion balance on the emotion nature in emotion balance. In the case of the low, they have the emotion balance. They calm, self-contained, bold, emotion stable and all. But they are emotion immature people in the case of the high level people. Therefore, if you look onto the five components, the first four components are first four factors of the high levels to be positive one. But in the low components of the first four components to be a negative one, it's like a low level. But in the case of the last components, it's talking about the high levels represent the negative aspects. In the low levels, talking about the high aspects. So only the first four, normally we meet it as a positive components. This may as a negative components like that in the scale when you go for measure. During your MR dissertation, you can understand what is a positive, what is a negative statement, and the same mechanism they adopted here. The same thing only, I'm giving as a different diagram. So you can see from here. Yes. Now I'm come for the conclusion about the this kind of trait approaches criticism. So already she asking some criticism. No? That's why I'm come to the criticism about the this much of traits theory is criticism, the critical analysis. This is my critical view or criticism of these traits. So what is the criticism in the sense of the all the traits? So still now we are discussing about the three traits approaches. One is Albert, second one is the Cater, the third one is the Big Wave Fodor. But what is the problem with this traits approach? All the theories being a purely descriptive and offering little explanations of the underlying process of personality. So, and also see here in the theory also, there is a two different end, like imagine the practical, original, conventional. But the people, sometimes they may be very neutral. But that kind of thing is not describing at anywhere in the trait approaches. So that is the biggest problem in the trait approaches, because most of the people may lies on the moderate level only. They are not going into low level, high level. But even the case of the cattle also, I told us here moderate. But in the case of the 16PF model suggested by the Cattle, he highlight only the low and high only. So he's not making any kind of moderate, but while I explaining, I use the term as a moderate level. But in the case of the Cattle, he focusing only the low as well as high only. That is a problem. And also the descriptions, the descriptive description when they provide in the theory aspect, so it's not that much of clear. That is the main problem with trait theories. Then lead some people to accept oversimplified and classified. See, that is also the problem. Even the case of the Alford theory, Cattle is not accepting. Similarly, the Goldsberg is not accepting the previous theories of the trait theories of the Alford as well as the Cattle. So each one having the different notions about the classification of the traits. So no one can come for conclusion about the standard traits things. That is the main problem in the case of trait theories. Then underestimate the effect of the specific situation on the people's behavior. Sometimes we could not come for any conclusions about the people's characteristics with some specific situations. So sometimes they may show some kind of behavior, some specific situation that we cannot come for conclusion about the people's personality that particular time. Then the poor predictors of the behavior. So even we cannot predict as it is the that's why the sanas are asking the questions. The problem with we cannot come for any kind of conclusions about the person's personality with these factors because it's making a lot of confusion in it. So this is the biggest challenges on the traits approach problems. So thank you all. I hope you understand the theories of the Big Five model and Big Five personality model. And the Big Five personality models, another name is called as an OSEN. So OSEN, the first term, the abbreviations, openness, conscientiousness, extroversion, as well as the agreeable, as well as the neuroticism. So hopefully you may understand both the theories we should discuss today. Thank you.